Other parameters, the value of all is think of that and it's good to go to the bathroom. Okay. Roving pocket health. Again. How can you measure the depth of the pocket or the depth of the surface? So you should, for that you should draw the normal surface. Look to the camera on the normal surface. When you measure, if it is more than 2 to 3 mm, that is, if it is more than 3 mm, it is considered to be a perioden pocket, which indicates that there is progression or there is existence of perioden disease or progression of perioden disease. So pocket depth is measured, or surface depth is measured from the surface depth is measured from the angle found in the face of the surface. So that measurement, if it is more than 2 to 3 mm, is called as perioden pocket. So pocket depth is measured from is the distance between the angle margin and base of the perioden pocket. Distance between the angle margin and base of the perioden pocket. The measurements on the basal and distal aspect on buccal and medial side should be same. Usually this is not the case as access from one side is better than the other. So, gingival recession, again, this is another parameter which shows that there is a perioden pocket. Gingival recession is, it can be due to various factors, but mainly it may be due to the formation of the perioden disease, or in the gingival tissues are affected. Gingival recession is distance from the cylinder enamel junction to the base of the perioden pocket. Gingival recession is the distance from the cylinder enamel junction to the base of the perioden pocket. This should be certain ideal capacity of perioden pocket. It should be fine enough to enter and have a perioden pocket. It must have a blunt end so that it does not penetrate the tissue. Perioden pocket should be narrow. And the edge of the looking end, tip of the pocket should be blunt so that it does not penetrate the tissue. Should be inserted as soon as possible to the long as possible, as near as possible to the long axis of the tooth. It should be inserted parallel to the long axis of the tooth. Okay. Then, now coming to the factors which contribute to the accuracy of the tooth, which factors which affect the accuracy of the perioden pocket, that is the size of the pocket, then the angulation of the pocket, then contour of the tooth, root surface, the probing force is used. Probing force considered to be 25 grams. But if it is more than 25 grams, it can penetrate into the tissue even though it is a dense tissue. So the force, probing force is very important. So size of the probe, angulation of the probe, size of it, as better of it should be thin so that it can penetrate through the periodontal surface, periodontal pocket. Angulation, how you angulate the probe, it should be mostly of commonly it should be parallel to the long axis of the probe and the contour of the tooth and root surface. The contour also affects the angulation of the probe. The probing force used, an inflammatory state of the tissue. Inflammatory state means if the tissue is inflamed, even with the normal force, the probe tip can penetrate deep into the tissue. So the inflammatory condition which can It is more than